नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम। द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम कंसिस्ट ऑफ प्राइमरी सेक्स ऑर्गन्स, दैट इज ओवरीज, एंड सेकेंड इज द secondary sex organs, that is oviduct uterus cervix वजाइना एंड एक्सटर्नल जेनिटेलिया। दैट इज कॉल्ड वुल्वा। तो फर्स्ट वी कम द ओवरीज। फर्स्ट वी विल ड्रॉ द डायग्राम ऑफ फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम सो दैट यू कैन इजीली अंडरस्टैंड द ईच एंड एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम। try to draw along with me. So you will not be bored. So now we start labeling. In Pandibulam, this part is called ampulla. This part is called isthmus. And these all comprises the oviduct. This part of the uterus is called fundus, and this part is called body of uterus. This is called internal os. Cervical canal. External os. Vagina. Hymen. Bartholin gland. So, let us revise it. In the female reproductive system, first part is come the pair of ovaries. These ovaries are located at the bottom of the abdominal cavity, just on the pelvic bones. These are joined by uterus called uterine ligaments and fallopian ligaments. With the help of these ligaments, these ovaries remain attached to the uterus, to the fallopian tube, and to the pelvic girdle of the female. The structure of the ovaries we will study in detail in the next lesson. Then comes the oviduct. So, in female, there are present a pair of oviducts. Each oviduct is divided into four regions. First of all, the infundibulum, it is funnel shaped, and at the end of this funnel there are present finger like projections. These finger like projections are called fimbri, and there is a opening, and this opening is called ostium. Then after infundibulum, there is a swollen part, and this swollen part is called ampulla. Then the duct changes into very narrow part, and this narrow part of the oviduct is called isthmus. So these four parts, that is isthmus, ampulla, infundibulum and fimbri, form the oviduct or fallopian tube. Now we will come the third part, and third part is the uterus. Uterus have three regions. The uppermost region is called fundus, it is swollen part. The remaining part, this part, is called the body of the uterus, and third part of the uterus is called cervix. This is called cervix. In a mature female, the uterus have three walls, that is perimetrium, myometrium and endometrium. When the girl is young, that is before maturation period, only perimetrium and a little developed myometrium is present. Perimetrium is made up of areolar tissue, while the myometrium is made up of muscular tissue. But during puberty, a third layer is also developed, and this third layer is called endometrium. So, uterus have three layers. Outermost layer is called perimetrium or epimetrium, made up of areolar tissue, and it protect the uterus. Second layer is myometrium. It is made up of muscles, and these muscles help in parturition. Third layer, innermost layer, that developed during puberty and after that, it is called endometrium. And this endometrium is highly vascularized. It is the part of the uterus, that is endometrium, which help in implantation. So, this body jo hai, it has three layers. Then uterus have third part, and this third part is called cervix. This cervix, it has a opening, and this opening opens into the uterine chamber. This opening is called internal os. The second opening which opens into the vagina is called external os. And in between the internal and external os, there is a canal. This canal is called cervical canal. So, cervix have three parts: internal os, external os and cervical canal. This cervix hang into the another tube that is called vagina. The vagina is about 7.5 centimeters long. Its inner wall is highly infolded, having the transverse folds made up of muscles, and the opening of the vagina is called vaginal orifice. In a young girl, this vaginal orifice is blocked by a perforated membrane called hymen. Just close to the hymen, the vagina have a pair of gland called Bartholin gland. This gland is just equal to the Cowper's gland in male. When the female excites, this gland secrete a lubricant and lubricate the inner lining of the vagina. Vagina receive the penis of male during intercourse. So, this is the structure of female reproductive system. In the next lesson, we will study about the ovary and its structure. Thank you.